Manila. Welcome to Peace Diplomacy Talk. Joining us right now is a Romanian diplomat, Her Excellency Raduza Dana Matake, the Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary of the Embassy of Romania to the Republic of the Philippines. Madam Ambassador, tell us your experience growing up in Romania.
I will, but thank you so much for pronouncing correctly my name. It's not evident. Well, I grew up in a city in the middle of mountains, a city like Baguio, or rather like Sagada, because my hometown is 400 kilometers far from the capital, Bucharest. I had a very happy and carefree childhood. School was within walking distance. I absolutely loved it. Ever since, I remained a firm believer in the importance of education, especially in the first years of school. I remember how dedicated our professors were. You know, when I look back with the experience of my age, I realized that it was a very modest environment, but the love and the stability that our families and our professors provided us turned it into an enchanted childhood. And let me say that an important part of my education were the trips that we took in the mountains. And these trips taught us very useful lessons. We learned to protect nature, to appreciate nature, and we learned to be there for each other in difficult situations. And we also had a lot of fun. And I would just mention that in our school, there was a lot of focus on sports. We could practice everything, gymnastics, volleyball, handball, skating. I believe very much in sport as one of the most important influences in a child's education. So a happy childhood.
Thank you very much. On that note, what were the important lessons you learned from your childhood?
All right. Well, that life is there to be lived and to be loved. That life is a gift that's given to you only once, and you have to make the most of it. Secondly, I would say I learned that friendships, relationships are far more important than any material possession.
Name and explain an important leader who inspired you.
Before coming to the Philippines in December 2021, I read a lot. I read everything I could find about Filipinos, Filipinas, and this your beautiful country. And I wasn't looking for a hero, but I found my hero in the process. I'm speaking about Carlos Romulo. I read two books about him, his biography, which is beautifully called I Walk With Heroes. And the book written by his wife, Betty de Romulo, about Carlos Romulo's life. And that book is called, I believe, The Writer, The Lover, The Diplomat. So I was absolutely fascinated and is inspired by Carlos Romulo. He had done it all. He was journalist at a very young age. He was a Pulitzer Prize laureate. He was a professor. He was a general, he was a diplomat, and he was the first ever Asian chair of the United Nations General Assembly. So he was a personality that I believe will remain a hero for Filipinos and non-Filipinos alike. I wish I could have met him, but unfortunately, may he rest in peace. He is long gone from us, but his memory is not.
Why is peace diplomacy essential in today's world?
Well, I believe all serious diplomacy is peace diplomacy. All of us thought we learned the lessons of World War II, the lessons of the Cold War. We thought that we would live peacefully ever after. Unfortunately, this is not the case. Still today in Europe, there is a terrible military aggression going on by Russia against Ukraine, two neighboring countries. And what's happening there is heartbreaking. People are dying. People are being displaced. There are waves of refugees all over Europe, including in my own country, which neighbors Ukraine. It's very disheartening to see that in the 21st century, we seem to be living again, reliving the horrors of the Second World War. Now, European Union, to which Romania belongs, is one of the powerful forces against war. And the European Union itself is a peace project, or if you want, a peace diplomacy project, an initiative which succeeded to replace hundreds of years of war between neighbors. That was Europe hundreds of years ago. So we replaced hundreds of years of war between neighbors with decades of diplomacy, negotiations, economic growth, increasing social harmony among European citizens, and to the point of today forging a common European identity complementary to our national identities. So I strongly believe that diplomacy and dialogue and negotiations in pursuit of peace, cooperation amongst nations, primarily neighbors, will always be relevant. As long as there are leaders ready to resort to warmongering, to killing their own neighbors, to sending to war their own citizens, sacrificing their lives of their own people and those of their neighbors for personal ambition or self-defeating narratives, as long as we have such leaders, diplomacy will be one of the most important instruments and one of the most needed professions in today's world.
Thank you very much. What makes Romania a unique country?
Thank you for this question. Well, without any doubt, I believe that the people make my country unique. They are happy people, warm, they have a good sense of humor. They are welcoming, hospitable. They preserve their tradition, but they are also strong and undeterred when faced with difficulties. Romania was the first majority Christian Orthodox country visited by a Catholic Pope. And on that occasion, Pope John Paul II called Romania Virgin Mary's Garden. And I believe that he was both referring to the beauty of my country, but especially to the character of the people that live in this Virgin Mary's garden. But also, every country is unique because it reflects the traits and the history of the people inhabiting it, isn't it?
Thank you very much, Ambassador Raduza Dana Matake. That's the Peace Diplomacy Talk for today. This is Rayron Del Rosario. Catch us for our next episode only here in IPDCI News Channel.